week two of the testimonies, and we welcome Steve Justice today. He attends Morningstar Church. He is the administrator there, as well as a minister. He is also the Fellowship of Christian Athletes director at Castlewood High School, and super involved in the youth in our area. And he is going to be sharing his testimony today with us. So, Steve, who is Jesus to you?
Jesus to me is opportunity. I've thought a lot about this the last couple of days. Not only opportunity for salvation and eternal life in heaven, but here on earth as well. Opportunity to persevere through things, opportunity to show love to others, opportunity to feel Him and show Him here without waiting until we get to meet Him in heaven.
That's good.
So, there's a lot of words you can say to describe Christ, Savior first and foremost, but I think opportunity covers it all. It gives us opportunity for so many things.
Amen. One of the things that Steve mentioned that really stuck out to me is that we don't have to wait till we get to heaven. And a lot of people confuse salvation with just a ticket to heaven, in which that is the ultimate goal. But on earth, we can have peace, we can have happiness, we can have joy. And all of this is through Christ. And that was something that you mentioned I thought was really good. So, Steve, can you tell us your testimony?
Yeah, I was raised in church all my life, knew the word, knew exactly what I was supposed to do, and like so many of us, I decided not to do it. I spent probably 15 years being a drunk. I don't want to say alcoholic, I know some people would, but to me, an alcoholic is when your body can't function without it. I can function just fine without it, I just chose not to. And finally, 7 years ago, almost to the day, I was going through some things and I was at my home. And God took a hold of me and I had no other option but to give in and gave my life to Him. Since that day, I've not had the desire to have a drink whatsoever. One thing I'd like to point out to people who may be new converts or prospective new converts to Christ, giving your heart to God and giving your life to God does not mean everything's going to be perfect. A lot of times we forget to tell people that when they get saved, trials will come, troubles will come. But the thing about it, like I mentioned earlier about opportunity, we have the opportunity through Christ to make it through all of those things. The fruit of the Spirit, she named a few of them earlier, we have that peace already instilled in us. It has to grow, but it is instilled in us the second that we accept Christ. The Holy Spirit comes to live in us and all those things come along with it. I had, as we all do, still have things that we go through. In the last 2.5 years, I think it is, I've lost a grandmother, an aunt, and an uncle that I was really, really close to. A marital separation, which I can honestly say, and I've said this publicly before, if it wasn't for Christ, I would be either in the ground or in prison now through all that. I would hate to think and imagine going through these things without Jesus. We talk about joy of the Lord. Joy is present when happiness is not. Happiness is more of an emotion. Joy is that peace that cometh without understanding that the scripture talks about. When you think there's no way you can have peace, God will give you peace. Your situation does not determine that. If you have Christ, that comes from Him and Him alone. A lot of the other things I've faced, I went through depression myself. I went to a point where I would sit on the couch and just stare at the wall. The TV would be on. Things would be going on around me. I had no desire to do anything, no joy whatsoever. And this was after I'd become saved. So the devil will still attack you. And the worst part is, from a physical standpoint and a natural standpoint, he will attack you harder if he knows that you're about to do some work against him. If he knows that that God has a calling on your life and that you've accepted Christ and that God has work for you to do, the attacks will be stronger. He's not worried about you if you're not going to do anything against him, anything to harm him. So the depression came. I fought through that with Christ. You know, that's not an easy thing for some people to talk about. For me, for a long time, it wasn't. I went a whole year and dared anyone, the few people that didn't know, to say a word. But it happens. It's real. It's an attack from the devil that comes straight from the pits of hell. You know, just like cancer is a physical thing and we can find physical ailments and physical reasons to say why it's there, it's still from the Satan. It's still from the enemy. And depression is the same way. And the difference between it and cancer or back injury or a broken leg or something, the depression side is stigmatized and people are ashamed to talk about it. And like I said, I myself was there. But it was revealed to me that through my sufferings, through the things that I go through with Christ, I can use that to help others. There's a lot of things that I can't talk to someone about. I can't talk to someone about drug addiction because I was never addicted to drugs. I can't talk to someone about several other things, but I can talk to someone about overcoming alcohol, about overcoming depression through Christ because I myself have went through that. And Paul talked about that. He went through so much in his travels and spreading the word of God that he could use that to help others. And just want to emphasize that we're all going through something. It doesn't matter if it's major, if it's small, if it's short term, if it's long term. We're all going through something. We all face storms. But Christ will see you through those. And if you don't have him, it's so much more difficult. You don't have that guarantee of peace in the midst of the storm. You don't have that guarantee of joy no matter what your situation is. But with Christ there, though you're still going through it, the situation does not determine your strength. The Bible says that when we're weak, he is strong. And he instills his strength in us to help us go through those things.
Can I ask you, when did, like with your depression, when were you able to overcome that through Christ? Like, what was the turning point there for you?
Actually, believe it or not, it was after my separation. I had more time with the Word. I grew in Christ. I had no choice. You know, you and I have talked about this 1,000 times. We get in the way of God by trying to do things on our own. Yeah. But when I hit that rock bottom spot, I didn't have the option. I had to look to God. So I grew closer to him. And that's when things started rolling as far as overcoming that. The real joy, the physical happiness and desire to do things came back. And it was all through Christ. I don't know exactly how things would have turned out without him, if I went through this before I came to him. But I do have a pretty good idea. And if this happened back when I was still living in the world and drinking, like I said, there's no doubt in my mind that I wouldn't be here, either on this earth or especially on this couch, but as a free man, I wouldn't, you know. So without Christ, there's no way that I could see coming through that. And it makes it so much easier.
Right. One of the things that Steve mentioned was that we can be a hindrance. And we can be a hindrance whenever that we try to control things. And whenever that we release that control to Christ and we give it to him and we're in full submission to him, that's whenever that his true will can come out. That's whenever the fruits of the Spirit can come out, because we're engulfed by the Holy Spirit at that point. And that's whenever peace, love, joy, meekness, temperance, all of the fruits of the Spirit can come out. And it's pretty awesome to have liberty and be free, isn't it? So, Steve, what is your favorite scripture?
My favorite scripture would have to be Romans 8 and 28. We know that all things work together for good to those that love God and those that are called according to his purpose. God doesn't send every storm to us, but he can use everything that comes against us. He can use it for good, not only for us in growth and strength, but as we mentioned earlier, to help someone else that may be facing the same thing.
Yeah. There is a saying, with every test, there's a testimony, and every mess, there's a message. So I sure am glad that even the bad situations are working out for my good.
Yep.
And for the glory of God, of course. So Steve,
yep.
For the ones who are suffering today, do you have any words of wisdom for them?
The most simple word of wisdom I can see is, if you don't know Christ, get to know Christ. Give your heart, give your life to Him. Because of all the things that we mentioned earlier, the opportunity we have to feel that joy and peace when we shouldn't. And if you do already know Christ and you're facing something, don't give up. There's something that I said once, that if you pray and you're praying and praying and praying and you get done and you don't feel relief, then you're not done praying. Keep praying. But I found it in studying scripture about praise. If you're done praying and you don't feel the presence of God, start praising. Praising you in the storm is what the song says. But His word says that He inhabits the praises of His people. That's a promise from God, that if we praise Him, that He comes to us. So whatever you're going through, praise God through it all. And it's hard to be thankful for trials, but you can still praise God for the things that are going well. The situation may not change, but the way you feel through the presence of God and your ability to get through it will. We spoke a couple weeks ago about the eclipse. We couldn't see the sun behind the moon when there was an obstacle in our way. But behind the moon, the power of the sun was still there. It didn't diminish. Nothing went away from it. And when we face obstacles and trials, we focus on that trial and we can't always see the power of God behind it. But the power of God doesn't diminish. The power of God doesn't move. It doesn't go away. It's still there. So focus instead on that power of God instead of the trial. It's something that takes time. It's something that's hard to do. We have to look through the eyes of Christ to do so. But prayer, staying in the Word, and praising God through it all is probably the best advice I can say to anyone that already knows Christ. And if you don't know Him, get to know Him. It's not just about salvation. That's the most important thing, that we can have an eternity in heaven with Christ. But it's a whole lot more than that. He said that He came that we would have life and have it more abundantly. Not just that we can have an afterlife more abundantly. There's a lot of things that Christ gave His life for that we are meant to have here on earth as well. So if you don't know Him, get to know Him. If you do know Him, get to know Him better. Spend time with Him.
That's good stuff. That is good stuff. Again, going back to Revelation 12:11, we're overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. That's what we are here to tell you, is that you may be going through trials of depression or separation or financial struggles, but these are all for the glory of Jesus Christ, and they are working an eternal weight in heaven and even on earth. And so, just like Steve said, whenever that we are weak, we know that God is strong.
Amen.
So we thank you so much for tuning in. We are going to be posting Steve's email at the end of this. My email will go on the end of this. If you're struggling with anything, with depression, alcohol, whatever it might be, don't allow the enemy to overtake you. Holler at one of us and we'll be more than glad to talk to you, or put you in contact with somebody who has overcome that situation. Thanks so much.